Students, today we are going to start our third unit, that is BD techniques. Okay, so what is GD technique means? Okay, see here, what is GD technique means? So here, GD method is generally designed, general design technique, and it is applicable to optimize problems only. So it is applicable for optimization problems only. So what is optimal problems means, just see here. So consider a problem of n inputs and require us to obtain subset that satisfy some constraints. So any subset that satisfy these constraints is called feasible solution. Okay, so any subset that satisfy these constraints, we call it as a feasible solution. So we need to find feasible solution that either maximize or minimize a given objective function. So here optimal solution must be best among all feasible solutions. So what is optimal means? For example, consider an input at one input at a time. So at each stage, a decision is made whether a particular input is an optional solution or not. Okay, that is a particular input as an optional solution. We are choosing that it as an optional solution. So consider the inputs in an order. If any input does not satisfy the constraint, then that input is not added the solution to the that is not added to the solution. If it is correct, then it is added to the solution. So here we have some general method is there, and another one is a knapsack problem is there. So here in this we cannot find a so an optimal problem is one in which you want to find not just a solution but the best solution. Okay, so here optimal problem means you just find the best solution for the given problem. So already told you greedy algorithm works for the optimization problems only. So here greedy algorithm works in stages. At each stage, it takes the best you can get right now without recording the for future consequences. Okay, hope that by choosing a local optimal at each step, you will end up at global optimum. So already the algorithm works in stages. So it's considering one input at a time. So at each stage, the decision is made regarding whether a particular input is an optional solution. Okay, so that is the added in the solution. Otherwise, that is not added in the solution. So this is done by considering the inputs in an order by some selection processor. So if the that by selection processor, we have to do this problem. So this is the algorithm for greedy. See here. Okay, this is the algorithm for greedy technique. So see here in this, so this is general algorithm. We are taking array from 1 to n contains the n inputs. Okay, solution is initialized to the, we have to initialize the solution. So you are taking for loop for I equal to 2 and I equal to n do. So x equal to select if feasible, then union. So result equal to solution. So what is this means? So in this, so here this the function select. So the function selects an input from A. And it means array, the input from array, and removes it. Okay, the selected input value is assigned to x. Okay, the once it selected from input from the user, and that is the input is assigned to x, and the selected input value is assigned to x. Okay, so here feasible, see here in this. So it initializes to x. Now we move to the feasible. So here feasible is a boolean value function that determines whether x can be included into the solution vector. So here it will check that where x can be included into the solution vector. So next, coming to the function union, combines x with the solution and update the object to function. Okay, so the function greedy describes the essential way that greedy algorithm will look. So once a particular problem is chosen and the function select, feasible, and union are properly implemented. Once you choose the problem, then the select, feasible, and union are properly implemented. Okay, so for this we have some problems are there. So see here select, here it will choose a candidate based on local selection criteria and remove it from candidate and return it to the value, just like stores the value in x. Feasible, check whether the adding the selected value to the current solution can result in a feasible solution. Okay. So this is the pseudocode for greedy. This is the pseudocode for greedy algorithm. Just write this in and I will just explain what is select and what is feasible and what is union. Next, coming to the optimization problem. So before moving to the optimization problem, there are some problems. You already know those problems. We studied in data structures. So those problems are, one is the Prim's algorithm and another one is the, one is the Prim's algorithm and another one is the Kruskal's algorithm. So for greedy techniques, we are using minimum spanning tree. Greedy technique is used in a minimum spanning tree. Okay. So this method, greedy method, is used in minimum cost spanning tree. All are you know about the Prim's algorithm. So Prim's algorithm, why we use the Prim's algorithm means, You have to find the cost. Find the cost for the input. So what is a spanning tree? So this will be minimum spanning tree by using the method of greedy technique. So what is the spanning tree? So a spanning tree of a connected graph is its connected acyclic subgraph, that is a tree that contains all the vertices of the graph. Okay, so a minimum spanning tree of a weighted connected graph is its spanning tree of the smallest weight today we discussed about the spanning tree, then we move to the remaining topics. So a minimum spanning tree of a weight connected graph is its spanning tree of the smallest weight, where the weight of a tree is defined as the sum of weights of all edges. So consider this example. You have A is there and B is there. C and D. Okay. So this is my graph. I am taking edges as one. Cost, I am taking the cost. In minimum spanning tree, we represent the values edges with cost. So in this, the smallest weight of a tree, we call it as the minimum spanning tree, which is a spanning tree. In this, we have to calculate the smallest weight of the tree, but all weights are visited, but the cost is low. So this will be, this can be represented in different formats. So this is case one, A to B, we can go, we can move, and A to C also we can move, and A to D also we can move. So what are the cost here? 3, 1, 5. Total cost is 9. Total weight equal to 9 here. Next, we can represent another way. A is there, then B, then C, then D. Okay, so in this, the cost, we just write the cost here, 2, 5. So here weight is, output weight is 8. So you can represent this graph in another form also. See here, A to B, A to D, so in this way we represent the graph in different ways. So the weight of this is 6. So then in these three, the minimum cost spanning tree is this one. So okay, clear? So all of you know about the Prim's algorithm. Okay, 1 minute. So we are seeing the Prim's algorithm. Okay, see here, this is the Prim's algorithm. So see here, Prim's algorithm is a famous greedy algorithm. Okay, so here it is used for finding minimum spanning tree. I already told you now, just I discussed the minimum spanning tree of the given graph, you have to use the Prim's algorithm. And also the given graph must be weighted, connected and undirected. Okay. So if you want to apply the Prim's algorithm, the given graph must be weighted graph and must be connected and undirected. Okay. Maybe connected, but we cannot perform undirected. So what are the steps to involve for Prim's algorithm? First, you have to choose any vertex randomly. It may be first vertex or second vertex, is anything. And the vertex connecting to the edge having least weight is usually selected. So we have some vertices are there. We are choosing one source vertex. So in that vertex consisting three or four edges, in that we have to choose the least weight. Okay. So I will explain it with an example. Then step two is find all the edges that connected to the new vertices. Okay. So just check the all the edges. When we are choosing one vertex, then check all edges that are connected to that vertex and find the least weight edge among those edges. Then you have to choose the least weight among those edges. And it include in the existing tree. Okay. Next, if it including the edges, create a cycle. If the edge is already visited, but you want to visit it once again, then it will create a cycle. Then reject that edge and look for the next least weight edge. If you already visited a vertex, we cannot, once you visited the vertex, you just move to the other frontwards. If you not again visit that vertex, it will create a cycle. So just reject that and move for the next weight edges. Okay. Next, see here, keep repeating step two until all included minimum cost spanning tree. Okay, this is the procedure. Now, see here, the time complexity for the Prim's algorithm is E means edges, E log V or E plus V log V for Fibonacci heap. For binary heap, this is the time complexity of worst case of Prim's algorithm. And for when using Fibonacci heap, this is the time complexity. So first consider this example. Okay, consider this example. I am choosing source vertex as 6. 6 is my source vertex. So then check the adjacent vertex. Adjacent vertex are 1 and 5. Then we have to choose which vertex is the minimum cost that we have to choose here. So 10 is the minimum cost. So we have to choose the first vertex 6 to 1. Okay, so here I am choosing the vertex 6 to 1. Then we move to the 1, then see the 1 adjacent vertex. So 1 we already come from 6 to 1, so we don't need to backward, just to move forward only. So 1 contains only 2 vertex, so directly connect to 2 and write the cast. Then you have to visit at 2. So 2 has 2 vertices, 7 and 3. Which one is minimum? You have to choose that. So here 7 is the minimum, you have to choose. Just see the diagram here. 6 to 1. Okay, no problem. Anything that is correct. Okay, just wrong step. So here we are checking another cost is 25, is that 28? So we move here 25. Okay, then you have to move the minimum cost after that. So here we have first we have to choose 10. Okay, then we have two minimum cost. Two costs are there. One is 25 and another one is 28. Which one is minimum is 25? Which one can move to the 25? Okay, then you move the vertex 5. So some why the adjacent vertex minimum cost is 24, 22, then move to the 22. Then from 4 onwards, you have to check the minimum cost, that is 12, 18, you move to the 12. Next from 3 directly 16. Okay. From 2, there is no need to move 1 because 18 just directly move to the 7. That is 2 to 7, 14. So the minimum cost of this tree is 10 plus 25 plus 12 plus. So total cost is 99 units. So consider this example. We first move, first store set is A. So we have to directly move A to B because the minimum cost. Then B to C, okay. C to D, C to F, F to 3, and E to 7, and C to 6. Okay, see here. A to B, B to C, C to F, F to E, E to C, F to C, C to okay, E or something F. So in this way, we have to calculate the Prim's algorithm. Okay, clear. Next, we move to the Kruskal's algorithm. So, here Kruskal's algorithm is also greedy algorithm. So same, it is used to find the minimum cost spanning tree. So here just we have to sort the all edges from low weight to high weight. Just you have to sort the all edges from low weight to high weight. Okay, then you have to take the edges with lowest weight and use it to connect the vertices of the graph. Just take the weight and write the edges and connect the graph. So I just see this point. If the adding an edge creates a cycle, then reject that edge and go for the next weight. Okay, so we will see this example by seeing one example here. So first write the vertices, so first one is in this minimum cost is 61, so I am taking 61. Next minimum cost is 423, so I took here 423. Next 72, I am took here 72, and next 16, 2 for 3 16, next 24, so already is there, so no need to come there. Then 25, 5 to 6, 25. Okay, next 4 to 12, next 14, next 16. Okay, next 22, next 25. Finally, the solution is 99. So, when you use the Prim's and Kruskal algorithm, the minimum cost for that is you have to calculate by PIMS algorithm. Just start choose one choose with a source vertex, then move forward by choose the minimum cost of that vertex and move forward until the we find the minimum cost for entry. If there are no cycles after completion of the after find the minimum cost, there are no cycles in the graph. So for Kruskal's algorithm, so just choose the cost from just sorted the data in ascending order. Then you have to just choose the vertices, then draw the graph after the choosing the vertices. Okay. So this is Kruskal's algorithm. Okay, anybody has any doubt? So then just refer the PIMS algorithm and Kruskal's algorithm. You're already familiar with those algorithms, I know that. Okay, next we move to the optimized problem. So what is an optimization problem means? So we have given a problem instance. So it contains a set of constraints and the objective functions. Okay. So for that we have to find a feasible solution for the given instance for which the objective function has an optional values. We have to find a feasible solution for the objective function as the optional values. So it may be either maximum or minimum depending on the problem being solved. Okay. So the feasible solution satisfies the problem constraints, and the constraint specifies the limitations on the required solution. Okay. Okay, so here the constraints specify the limitations on the required solution. So for example, we are considering the knapsack problem. So what is the knapsack problem means? So what is the knapsack problem means? See here, just see the knapsack problem. So a knapsack with limited weight capacity. So in this, we have some baggage there. In that, we have to kept a few items, and each item having some weight and value. So we have to just kept these items into that bag. That problem we call it as a knapsack problem. So here the problem says, so which item should be placed into the knapsack? Knapsack is nothing but the bag. So which item should be placed into the knapsack such that the value or profit obtained by putting the item into the knapsack is maximum? So you have to put the value or profit obtained the item into the knapsack is maximum. So, and the weight limit of the knapsack does not exceed. So, we have to check the weight limit of the bag does not exceed, and also we have to check the profit is maximum. So, this is the knapsack problem. So, here we have one bag. The bag will have capability and can handle 15 kgs weight. Okay. So how we solve this knapsack problem? So here we have 12 cages is there, and 2 cages is there, and 1 cage, 4 cages and 1 cage, but for 12 cages $4, for 4 cages $10. So here we are not exceeding the 15 cage size. Back. So if you choose the 12 cages and 4 cages, then the cost is high, but the bag size is exceeded here. So you have to check the bag side as well as okay. So you have to check the bag is not full, and also you have to check the profit is maximum profit you get that. When you fill the bag, you have to get the maximum profit, and you have to don't exceed the high size. Okay. So your knapsack problem has the following two variants. One is fractional knapsack problem, another one is 0/1 knapsack problem. Okay, so this here, so fractional problem means here the name suggests items are divisible here. Okay, in this items are divisible here. So we can even put the fraction of any item into the knapsack if taking the complete item is not possible. Okay. So how can it will be solved using greedy method? Step one, see here, for each item, compute its value or weight ratio. Then step two, arrange all the items in decreasing order of their value and weight ratio. Okay, then you have to, step three is start putting the item into the knapsack, beginning from the item with the highest ratio, and also put as many items as you can into the knapsack, but it cannot exceed the size of the problem, size of the bag. Okay. So here, okay, see here, we are writing here item 1, weight 5, value 30, item 2, weight 10, value 40, item 3, weight 15, value 45. Okay, so find the optimal solution for the fractional knapsack problem using, so n equal to 5, weight equal to 60 kgs. So you have to first compute the value. Okay, just to see the steps here. This is the problem. Just first to understand the problem. Okay, so first see that what is the optimization problem, then we discussed about this. Okay, you just better understand about this problem. Okay. Now just see the algorithm here. So see the steps here, what we are going to do. Okay, so far clear? Anybody had any doubt, please write a message. Just I will explain this algorithm with an example. Okay, so see, I am taking one example for NAFSAC problem. So I am taking one example for NAFSAC problem, and I will explain with that with an example. So we have objects are there. We have objects. Total we have 7 objects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next we have profits. So profit is for this object is 10 and this is 5. And this one is 15, and this one is 15, and this one is 7, and this one is 6. Next, this one is 18 and this one is 3. Okay, then what are the weights for this? Weight. So this one is weight is 2 and this one weight is 3 and this one weight is 5 and this one weight is 7. This one weight is 1, 4 and 1. Okay. So, see here in this, the bag contain. Okay, 10, 5, 7, and what are the weights here? 10, 5, 15, 7, 6, 18, and we have some see here 6, 7 is there, then 3. And here in this we have the weighted, what are the weights here? Here 2, 3, 5, 7, 1, 4, 1. So here the we have n equal to 7 means total objects are 7. What is the bag can handle the minimum capacity weight it can handle is 15 kgs. So what we have to do for this? Okay. Okay, so in this which one is which objects we have to store in this bag? It contains its capacity 15 kgs only. So which objects is can be stored in this? So anybody can tell which how we can store these items by using the greedy method? So we have to find the optimal solution for this problem. So what we have to do, we will discuss this example tomorrow. Just we have to concentrate on what is greedy method. So which techniques we are used to perform greedy methods. So here we are using Prim's algorithm, Kruskal algorithm, disgusters also we are using in greedy method, greedy techniques. Algorithm method also use the greedy method technique. Okay, so just what is the, for example, what is the divide and conquer technique? So what is the divide and conquer algorithm? So here we have to divide the problem into sub problem and find the solution to that problem. We call it as a divide and conquer. In the same manner, greedy technique means we have to choose any one value, then we have to randomly choose that value, give the current solution to the given problem. So that is the greedy method. Okay, so here, so if you consider a problem of n inputs and requires us to obtain a subset that satisfies some constraints. So any subset that satisfies these constraints is called feasible solution. So we need to find a feasible solution that either maximum or minimize a given objective function. Okay. So here optimal solution must be best among all feasible solutions. Okay. So for this we used we already discussed about two algorithms. One is discussed about minimum spanning tree algorithm. So we have two algorithms are there, one Prim's algorithm and Kruskal's algorithm. Okay. So this is about the greedy technique, and tomorrow we will discuss what is the Prim's algorithm, what is the Kruskal's algorithm, what is the knapsack problem. We discussed it with some example. Okay, today I end the session. Okay. Tomorrow.